What I want to do in this video is compare the fractions 3/4 and 4/5 and 4/5. And I want to do this visually. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have two copies of the same whole. So let me draw that. But I'm going to divide the first one. So let's see, we have, so this is one whole right over here, this rectangle. Let me draw the whole thing. So this is a whole. And right below that, we have the same whole. We have a rectangle of exactly the same size. So right here, we have a rectangle of exactly the same size. Now you might notice that I've divided them into a different number of equal sections. In the top one, I've divided it into 4 equal sections because I'm concerned with fourths. I've divided this top whole into fourths, and I've divided this bottom whole, or this bottom bar, or this bottom rectangle, into fifths. Or five equal sections. So let's think about what 3/4 represent. So that's going to be one of the fourths right over here. That's one of the fourths, two of the fourths, and then 3/4. And what is 4/5 going to be? Well, 4/5 is going to be 1/5, 2/5, 3/5, and 4/5. So when you look at them visually, remember, we're taking fractions of the same whole. This is 3/4 of that rectangle. This is 4/5 of the same sized rectangle. It wouldn't make any sense if you were doing it for different shapes or different sized rectangles. We just divided them into different sections, and you see that if you have 4/5, that is going to be more than 3/4. And so 4/5 is greater than 3/4, or you could say 3/4 is less than 4/5. Or any way you want to think about it, the symbol you want to use always opens to the larger number. 4/5 is larger than 3/4, so the large end of our symbol is facing the 4/5. So we would say 3/4 is less than 4/5.